the developers and how we can drive the applications locally with you here for the Windows Phone ecosystem. And of course, what we can do together and how we can support in Central East Europe with our colleagues here locally from the offices to make the applications be available. So I will start with, say, very shortly, Nokia strategy, because it was changed and updated in the previous year, and actually how we drive forward with the smartphone business and applications. Then I will explain why actually we have the partnership between Nokia and Microsoft. What's in it actually for the future? What Nokia brings to partnership, what Microsoft brings to partnership. And then we will be talking about what's really, like, say, the bread and butter for us, which is where is the marketplace with application, how we can support you, what's in it for you, how we can develop with the tools, seeding devices, etc. But if there are any questions, you know, let's probably jump them on the call or leave till the end part of the presentation. We'll definitely have some minutes to address any questions that we may have. Okay. Shortly from the strategy, I would say that's a very simple one. We are here to bring the great mobile products, which is actually the Nokia core business. So since a couple of years, you know, Nokia Kinetic device, which actually, when you bend the device, you know, you, for example, if there is a photo, then you zoom in the photo. Or when you bend it out, then you know, zoom out of photo. When you bend the angle of the device, left angle, you go to the menu. So it's just innovative technologies that somehow in the future will be deployed in the next products. The next one is this, we call it connecting the next billion. It's about mobile phones. So Series 40 products, Qt products, Symbian products that we deliver here. Why we talk about this? Because in general, there are 3 billion people in the world who has the mobile phone or smartphone, but it means the next 3 billion people needs to be addressed. Of course, this is like markets like China, Brasilia, Russia, India, etc., where they need simple products like Nokia Series 40 products, which also are very popular in Central East Europe. But actually, it means it's not only for, you know, SMS or call, it's much more, because they need internet, so browsing, and they need applications. So Foursquare application, WhatsApp application with chat are there, and also our role here is to bring these more local applications for them. For smartphone business, we entered in the previous year, February 2011, the partnership with Nokia and Microsoft. And now we are after the year from the announcement and actually already brought like two products in the market, which we'll also enjoy here in the market in April in Bulgaria. But actually you were informed about four products that will come still in Q2 this year to the market. When I think about this Nokia-Microsoft partnerships, you know, I think this is like a partnership of two adult people, of two adults, experienced guys, who actually know exactly what are their strengths, what is the best from, I would say, both worlds from here. Because in this partnership, you know, let's just take a look what Nokia brings, say, from the left side here. Nokia brings the global distribution of the devices. Right? Nokia is well known from the, you know, very good hardware quality, simple user interface, good battery life, etc. And the global distribution, meaning that we can deliver any product to the world, whatever it's America, is it Asia, is it, you know, Bulgaria with local language, within maximum 21 days from the orbit to any place with any software. Of course, consumer reach. Also, the possibility to have local languages, local variants with local applications on the device. On the other hand, what Microsoft brings to the partnerships, it's of course the new, completely new Windows Phone system that was also disclosed and described on the conference here. Very simple one, intuitive with Metro user interface, panorama design, fantastic software development kits, developer kits that we touch this a little bit later. Very simple social client on the device which integrates communication around the people. So if I want to discuss and communicate with Kalayan, I see exactly what he puts on Facebook, on Twitter, on his contacts, SMS call into one of people hub around. On the other hand, what Nokia brings is this global distribution, but also the software. For example, Nokia Maps, the new release which was done in the previous week. The navigation, Nokia transportation in several markets as well. What we bring together is the business communication. So, for example, we bring together with the Microsoft Office available on Nokia devices. Smoothly, without extra cost, you will see this in a second. So the whole Microsoft package is there, including the audio. Right? From entertainment, actually we bring both, because Nokia brings Nokia Music, Microsoft brings Zoom or Xbox Live here. Then we talk about store with applications. Nokia has Nokia Store for Cute series for the Nico devices. Microsoft has Marketplace for Windows Phone devices. And of course here is the biggest role of the third party like developers to bring the most relevant local applications into these stores. And this partnership is signed for several years. It's not just one-off deal. So it's about complementary both worlds from each parties, right? You can easily imagine what will happen in the future, right? For example, we have, say, Nokia Windows Phone, Nokia Lumia Windows Phone. Then we have a navigation, right? Then we can have, say, to utilize Ad Center for the future. And if I also put my profile, if I am here in Bulgaria, for example, and I am the fan of Nike or whatever, then I can receive, based on my profile, only relevant advertisement on my mobile, that if I go actually to the nearest Nike shop, for example, I have a discount if I only show this advertisement, you know, to the counter clerk. So that's the potential growth for that. In terms of actually why we talk about that, that's very obvious. Wherever we talk with the mobile operators, they talk about the need for the creating the whole ecosystem, the third ecosystem. So actually that's addressing this need. Because, for example, based on 2011 pyramid research here, you see that when Nokia announced with the partnership with Microsoft in 2011 February, and then informed about that actually next device is coming, which happened after 9 months, is Nokia Lumia 800, Nokia Lumia 710, the new devices like Nokia Lumia 610 and 900 that Karolyan will be discussing later. Suddenly the forecast from different market researchers appeared that actually when they expand the ecosystem, they expand later the ecosystem based on next release of Windows Phone or Windows operating system, it can appear and drive very, very highly into the very tangible from 20 to 30% market share perception, depending on is it IDC, is it pyramid research. When we talk with the developers more and more and show the devices and give them devices for trialing the applications also, they say to us, and this is actually based on the Visual Mobile studies in June 2011, what are the top important criteria for developing the applications? So for example, here it's mentioned like large market penetration. So actually the markets that I can address the application globally, not only locally. I will be touching these cases from Central Eastern European developers who are actually global, locally in Poland or Czech Republic, but they enjoy more than 1 million downloads from Nokia Store currently, which are available from global markets, right? The second, of course, is about low-cost development tools, which actually Microsoft brings SDKs here as very important, and the revenue potential, so either premium SMS or monetization with mobile operator billing as such. And also with the same Vision Mobile research in 2011, Windows Phone was mentioned like the second biggest opportunity when Nokia and Microsoft announced this partnership and brought this ecosystem into place on first Nokia 800 devices, Nokia Lumia 710 devices, and the next one which will be coming also till the middle of this year. What's unique and where is the momentum of the Nokia Lumia? This is a public page when we put, you know, this one which you can always go anytime, you know, for the future, but this is actually how Nokia Lumia devices momentum is bringing up globally to the world. So in February 2011, when the partnership was done, there was like a totally blank, like zero, nothing. No devices, no coverage. Right now we speak about the really global reach, because quite recently announcement about USA entering the market with Nokia 710. The whole Europe is coming here. Bulgaria will join in April. China, which was announced yesterday, of course, very important market. India, Brazil is also already there. So actually, the expansion within the year is huge. It's extremely dynamic right now. Why we talk about this? Because from developers' point of view, it's even bigger opportunity, not only the local one, but the global one as such. Right?
We will be talking later about currently 4 Lumia smartphones available. We talk about expansion of the market. Currently, the countries that Windows Phone Lumia is available is 37. And number of operators who support launch of Nokia Lumia right now is 80. With number of available applications, as we speak today, 72,000. And growth is 300 a day. So as we speak today, next 300 applications will appear in marketplace. Huge dynamic from the year in February 2011 when actually the partnership was done. What's unique from our side, from Nokia? Some services. For example, Nokia Drive, right? Navigation here. That is absolutely available, like unique one for Nokia, Lumia, Windows Phone devices. Well, you may say it's a very simple solution, right? It's just the navigation which is available like turn by turn in 104 countries, so it's really global, with the local voice guidance currently available in more than 50 languages, which you can download, for example, from the marketplace. It's very simple, it's intuitive, it supports the car, you know, very efficient model in terms of either you can put it like portrait, if you want to do it, or you can make it like horizontal one, horizontal and vertical one, depending on your preference. It shows very basic information which is needed from my driver car perspective here, like, you know, the speed, the distance, distance to the final destination, time to the destinations, and it also prompts me, it warns me if I'm speeding over the speed limits as such. What is very, very important, that we can actually download the country maps from my Lumia devices through, for example, hotspot or operator network. So it's extremely important because since a week, this navigation is available also in offline mode. So for example, if I'm coming here to Bulgaria, what I do at home, I download the Bulgaria maps immediately, right? And then if I'm coming here, I'm just using the navigation in the offline mode without any data charges, roaming, which is of course huge, or additional possibility to buy a local card, right? That's extremely important and extremely useful right now with global coverage. The second one is the Nokia Maps. So you may say, of course, maps available on Nokia devices, more and more precise, more and more poise coming into the Nokia Maps. I would say it's very self-explanatory. So we have the maps, we have the coverage here. We have the points of interest, name it restaurants, hotels, bancomats, name it fuel station, name it whatever you like. Whenever you press, then you have the possibility to go into the navigation mode. And then depending if you drive, then it goes you with drive navigation or pedestrian walk navigation. Or in some markets also, there is available public transportation. So for example, this covers like 510 cities in 46 markets right now. For example, if I go, say, for example, in Krakow, in my hometown, then I go, say, I want to go from this place to the another place, but it means, okay, it shows me, go 5 minutes to this tram station, use this tram, which is number here and here, for the next five, you know, stops, get off the tram here, and next make walking by another 100 meters or so, which is very convenient. So this is about that. Strategic partnership Nokia-Microsoft, unique services from Nokia on top of it, like maps, like navigation, but also something which is very, very important for all of us, because we are just also the business people as well. I would say very simple and smooth connection towards what's important in my business life, what's important in my business solution. Because I think, like majority of us, we all are using the Microsoft services, like Microsoft Outlook, based on Exchange, or simply Microsoft Office, name it on home computer or, you know, personal and just computer which I am using in the work. Like, so the whole Office package, PowerPoint, Excel, Word with editing and possibilities. Or, for example, we have these possibilities to connect, which is very modern right now, to going to the cloud services, like using SharePoint. Or for my private use, the free SkyDrive space as well. Right? So I'm using this very, very, very frequently using right now because, for example, if I go here with just a pure device, I can connect from here to the SharePoint, download the presentation that we discussed with Kaloyan, and off we go. That's it. As simple as that. Email, we may say it's obvious. So very smooth integration with Outlook because it's simply Microsoft. That's it. Operating system with Nokia device based on the same one. But also it integrates the other email inboxes which you have. Name it Nokia Mail, name it Gmail, whatever it is. And last, which was added quite recently, the link communicator, which is also available here, so we can chat, we can have a presence available on these devices and communicate with Nokia Lumia Windows Phone as such. We talked about the strategic partnership, we talked about services and business applications which are connected smoothly without any extra, you know, servers or licenses to be paid. But of course, the top important and crucial one is the next element of the ecosystem, which are devices and smartphones. And here, if I would like to ask Kaloyan to talk about what's new in the Nokia Lumia smartphones.
Здравейте от мен. Казвам се Калоян Канов и съм част от екипа на Nokia, който отговаря за Балканите, България в частност. Както чухме вече, наистина ние се опитваме да изградим една истинска екосистема, която да е изградена от своите компоненти. Разбира се, устройствата, които идват от страна на Nokia, са изключително важна част от тази екосистема. Ще ви покажа няколко устройства и ние сме изключително горди с това, че в рамките само на 8 месеца след обявяването на стратегическото партньорство между Nokia и Microsoft да покажем на света първият модел на Nokia, базиран на операционната система Windows Phone, и това е Nokia Lumia 800, която е в момента нашето флагман устройство от висок клас, устройство, таргетиращо различен тип потребители и хора, които са заинтригувани предимно от смартфони, даващи им изключителни възможности. Възможности да пътуват, но и по време на това пътуване да бъдат винаги онлайн с нещата и в част с нещата, които се случват около тях. Какво имам предвид? Както Дарюш вече спомена, ние с това устройство предлагаме различни начини на комуникация, които крайният потребител може да се възползва от тях, като говорим както за социалния живот, така и за бизнес живота на човек. Но да погледнем в частност детайлите на този телефон. Какво е важно тук? Като един истински представител на високия сегмент, телефона е с изключително добър хардвер, както може да видите от характеристиките по-долу. Но за нас е също така важно, че ние имаме някои неща, които ни отличават и ни правят забележителни сред морето от устройства, които има на пазара. Първото нещо, за което искам да кажа няколко думи, това е дизайна на устройството. Този дизайн е разработен от Nokia, специално звено в Nokia е работила доста дълго върху дизайна на това устройство. И целта на Nokia е да направи този дизайн наистина забележителен и разпознаваем сред потребителите. Това е и обратната връзка, която получаваме вече от потребителите, тъй като устройствата са вече някакво известно време на пазара. Хората разпознават този тип дизайн, той е изключително добре прият и се радва на сериозен успех. Малко повече в думи за самата технология. Първото така сериозно и важно нещо е дисплея на телефона. В дисплея на телефона се вложи наистина доста усилия, доста труд. И в резултат имаме един изключително ярък дисплей, който ви позволява да използвате възможностите на телефона, възможностите на операционната система, както вътре в затворено пространство, но също така с тази яркост, с тези цветове и с интеграцията на софтуера по същия начин навън на слънчева светлина. Как става това? Това се дължи благодарение на Clear Black технологията. Clear Black е технология, която Nokia използва в своите телефони. Доскоро беше налична в по-високия сегмент устройства, но Съвсем скоро с устройство като Asha 303 този тип дисплей вече е в по-достъпен клас устройство. Но какво има предвид? Този дисплей, Clear Black дисплея, премахва отблясъците на слънчевата светлина. Тоест, когато аз съм навън на ярка слънчева светлина, не е нужно да гледам телефона от различни ъгли, а мога да го използвам така, както би го използвал тук в залата. Също така, нещо много важно за дисплея е усещането, което потребителя получава, когато работи с самия дисплей. За целта, разстоянието между дисплея и стъклото е премахнато, т.е. нямаме пространство между дисплея и стъклото, което да е взето от въздух, и затова потребителя получава усещане, че той наистина взаимодейства с самия софтуер, докосвайки дисплея на телефона. Естествено, самото стъкло е Gorilla Glass. Смятам, сте добре запознати с технологията. Това е изключително устойчиво стъкло на различен тип потребители, хора, които носят телефона си в чанта, могат да се опитат да го надраскат по някакъв начин, но наистина стъклото е изключително издържливо на изтърване при всекидневна употреба, издържливо при удар в различни твърди предмети. Затова, имайки предвид, че ние искаме наистина да предоставим едно качествено изживяване на нашите потребители, това стъкло е намерило място в този телефон. Разбира се, AMOLED технологията, която е в основата на дисплея, също дава много това взаимодействието между устройството и потребителя да бъде наистина на едно много високо ниво. Говорейки за дизайн, също така трябва да отбележим самия корпус на телефона. Телефона е създаден от най-високотехнологичния материал, познат на индустрията в момента. Специален поликарбонат, който е наистина изключително устойчив и има няколко важни характеристики. Както виждате, телефоните са достъпни в няколко различни цвята. Този в ръката ми е черен, пред вас е синия вариант, известен като циан. Също така имаме вариант, който се казва магента, който е в червената гама. Но какво е важното тук? Всички знаем, че при всекидневната употреба един телефон може да бъде изтърван или надраскан по някакъв начин, което води до различни белези върху корпуса на телефона. Предимството на този тип материал и на този дизайн е, че цветовете, които виждате върху корпуса на телефона, са също така инжектирани в самия материал. Тоест, ако аз надраскам този телефон, дръскотината няма да е толкова ясно видима, защото цвета, който е върху корпуса на телефона, по същия начин, същия цвят е във вътрешността на материала. Тоест, отдолу нямаме някакъв друг цвят, който да прозира или да се вижда, когато се случи нещо с самия телефон. Както се вижда от слайда, изключително сериозно внимание е отделено на дизайна и на качеството на изработка на всяко едно устройство. Дори всяка една дупчица на високоговорителя на телефона се прави с изключително внимание и от специални машини. Пак казвам, идеята и причината да отделяме изключително внимание върху нашите устройства, за да предоставим възможно най-качественото и добро преживяване за нашите потребители. Смартфоните винаги са интересна тема, както за нас като производители, така и за операторите, които ги предлагат, така и за аудиторията, която е тук, има предвид девелопъри. Но не бива да забравяме, че смартфоните също така се използват и от различен тип потребители. Всеки би искал да има възможно най-високия клас телефон, но какво обаче, ако няма възможност да си позволи това? Точно поради тази причина ние също така се радваме, че можем вече да отправим следващото предложение към нашите потребители. И това е следващия модел, Nokia Lumia 710. Какво е важно за този телефон? Всичко, което казах преди малко за 800, вниманието, което е отделено за разработката на този телефон, важи в пълна сила за Nokia Lumia 710. Както виждате, хардуерните параметри на този телефон също са на едно доста високо ниво и правят телефона изключително конкурентен спрямо различни предложения на пазара. Но важното тук е, че този телефон също така е достъпен. Този телефон чисто ценово е ориентиран към по-широка маса хора. Причината за това, както казах, много хора искат и биха се радвали да използват смарт телефони, биха се възползвали от техните възможности и това всъщност е причината такъв тип устройства да бъдат интересни от гледна точка на девелопери, защото колкото по-широка е масата потребители, която може да се таргетира, толкова по-добре. Затова ние вярваме, че това устройство, особено за пазари като България, които са изключително ценово ориентирани, ще бъде следващия така много, много успешен модел. Също така не бива да забравяме, че за ценовия сегмент, в който се намира това устройство, имаме изключително сериозни характеристики, като 3,7-инчов AMOLED дисплей, който отново е с издръжливото стъкло, 5 мегапиксела, изключително бърз процесор, сериозна батерия, които да дадат едно добро преживяване на крайния потребител, но не бива да забравяме и тези две много важни условия. Навигацията, която чухме от Дариуш, навигацията в България наистина изключително богата към съдържание. Страната е покрита на 100% като територия и население. В момента се работи изключително много върху разширяването на съдържанието в самите карти. Дори с последната версия, която мога да ви демонстрирам малко по-късно на този телефон, имаме различни точки на интерес, като да кажем Александър Невски, Президентството, Народно събрание, които са визуализирани в 3D обекти на картата. Също така картите са богати на изключително много съдържание от гледна точка на места за посещения, ресторанти, заведения, кина и така нататък. Тъй като ние смятаме, че има различни потребители и отново, за да покажем нашия сериозен ангажимент спрямо всички потребители на пазара, спрямо нашия съюз с, Microsoft, между Nokia и Microsoft. Ние сме също така горди, че наскоро представихме още един модел, което показва, че не говорим само за едно или две устройства, които да представим на пазара, а наистина ще представим рейндж от устройства, които също така ще бъдат достъпни на българския пазар. Следващия модел, който наистина така стана известен наскоро, е Nokia Lumia 900, който също ще бъде достъпен на българския пазар. Естествено, това е един изключително интересен и добър смартфон, позициониран в високия клас, с изключителни хардверни характеристики. Както виждате, 4,3 Clear Black дисплей, с също това издържливо стъкло, за което говорих преди малко, с същите възможности за графична обработка, за интеракция с софтуера, същите високи възможности, които би могъл да се възползва всеки потребител от гледна точка на бизнес или на социален живот. И естествено, разбира се, цветовата гама. Цветовете са нещо, което от наша гледна точка е изключително важно и много от нашите модели се радват на изключително цветово разнообразие. Както виждате, модела, който ви представям в случая, е с бял корпус. Отново изработен от този изключително издръжлив поликарбонат, за който стана дума. И четвъртия модел, за който искам да кажа няколко думи, е модела Nokia Lumia 610. Модел, който таргетира наистина масовата аудитория. Пак казвам, всеки от нас би желал да има висок клас телефон, скъп телефон, но не бива да забравяме, че хората навън са много най-различни, и всеки от тях би се радвал да използва възможностите, които един съвременен смартфон, базиран на Windows Phone, представен от Nokia, би му предложил. И това е причината да ви представим Nokia Lumia 610, който всъщност ще бъде още по-достъпен, още по-атрактивен ценово за всички потребители, които са на пазара, но въпреки това ще ви може да се увидите по-късно от семплите, които са тук. Въпреки достъпната си цена, предлага същото това преживяване, както и телефоните от по-висок клас, което вярваме ще го направи изключително конкурентен спрямо другите модели, които се намират на пазара в момента. Виждате характеристиките му, 3,7-инчов дисплей с изключителни възможности, изключително бърза връзка и интеракция, когато човек браузва в интернет, благодарение на Internet Explorer 9, навигацията достъпна отново на този телефон и не бива да забравя също възможностите на камерата, които предоставя. В общи линии това са устройствата, пак казвам, това са първите устройства, които ние наскоро представихме, искахме да ги представим на вас днес и да ви кажем, че те също ще бъдат достъпни в България в така много скоро време. И искахме да споделим наистина основните неща, които са за тях и да обясним защо ние всъщност се движим в тази посока. Отново Дарио ще ви каже няколко думи за нещата, които сме подготвили да споделим относно приложенията, това, което прави този телефон, този смартфон, имам предвид като категория, интересен за потребителите на пазара в момента.
So now we discussed about these devices as an enabler for the services like maps, navigation, other services like public transportation. Now coming to the very important subject for us, which is application. And of course, Nokia has a lot of experience with the application because of the current Nokia Store that is available for our devices, so like Series 40 devices, Symbian devices, Mingo devices as such. So actually it gives us a very good way and paved the way towards the next developments on the Windows Phone as such. Just to give you a snapshot, currently in the Nokia Store we have 13 million downloads of the different elements from the store daily. So it's happened right now as we speak, several downloads per week. That's a really global one. In terms of more than 190 countries are supported for the Nokia Store and 90 with the local languages, which is extremely important for the local people to manipulate and of course download with the stores. Important is also the monetization from developers' point of view and operators' point of view, how to get money of the applications from the store, which is actually that more than 50 countries have the local payments, named Premium SMS for example, and this is available with 140 global operators. That's important from the developer point of view because once the application is published, it goes usually everywhere, globally. Right? So it could be there, you know, in any place which we even didn't expect. And for example, with that, 350 developers have more than 1 million downloads of their own application, globally as such. Currently minimum 5 from Central East Europe, 1 from Poland, 1 from Czech Republic. And this is exactly how the scale of the globality is here, because if it is a game, right, it's not only, let's say, for Polish market as such, it could be available anywhere. And when I took the statistics, for example, the most downloadable this Polish game was, say, from India, then from China, partially from UK. So it's really, really global, it goes really then everywhere. Currently, the volume of applications is available for more than 100,000, but what is really more important, that 80% of the traffic when the people go to the store, browse, look for applications, etc., is converted to the downloads. Majority of them are free, of course, for the application, but also because of these premium SMS availabilities, they are also available as paid. In terms of the marketplace, yep, the same store with, say, application, games, music, videos for Windows Phone. So Nokia Windows Phone comes under the marketplace here, as you see with this Metro user interface possibilities, panorama, etc. Very impressive because since the February 11th, the previous year, till now, end of March, there is a huge growth in dynamics in terms of the application available there. It's starting from 7,000 a year ago,
Now it grew to 72,000 as we speak today, with the pace of 300 applications developed daily. So also today the next 300 applications will be developed and published to the marketplace. Previously, a year ago, it was the pace of 100 applications, so 200% more on top of this one. Also, today there was an announcement that we had new markets to be available for the marketplace, partially also coming from Central East Europe, which is a very good sign for all of us, very good opportunity as such. And also, when we talk about the global availability of the marketplace, also we put a lot of attention to support developers for local relevant applications, because usually this is the one which is the most desired from the local environment, and probably the same will happen in will be available will be important for Bulgarian markets. When we talk about the marketplace opportunity, you see it's a very simple in terms of user interface, in terms of experience. Usually they say like the top important element which is highlighted. Then we have selection of say Nokia store, Nokia applications on Nokia Windows devices when you find maps, navigation, music in certain markets, public transportation, etc. Then you have categories like apps, application, games, music, podcasts, whatever. When you go to applications, then you have highlighted applications, which could be merchandised, promos, and of course similar in the other categories like games, podcasts, music, etc. Also, in the other layout, there are like featured application, or top, or new, or bestsellers, etc. Right? Important is, because that's a huge opportunity that we with Microsoft can offer from developers in terms of merchandising of the applications in the local marketplaces. And just from the experience which is happening right now, because we simply monitor what happens if we put the application into the featured icons, what happens if we put the application into the featured list, you know, for the certain period of time. The result speaks for itself. You know, usually the downloads of this application in this given period when the application is featured either in the list or in these iconic ones goes with, say, enormous increase on the basis, but that's of course obvious as such. Simple navigation, very large displays which are available here, merchandising concept, merchandising spotlighting, and easy to search for the application with the search functionality in the marketplace creates this very simple opportunity from end users to really go and check what's new and check what's new and download the application as such. So actually what it means for you, what's we need for you in terms of the developers, it's just the opportunity that we bring, you know, from the devices perspective, new for devices coming to the market, which was never before. Also, very important, what we checked right now from the current experience from the other markets, including also Central East European markets, that average user who already has the Nokia Windows phone downloads 12 applications per month, which is very high engagement if we compare to the other platform as such. The applications are growing in the speed of these 300 applications per day, and we need local applications extremely in a high volume as such. And of course there will be next markets available and next markets to be joining from developers' point of view to this global available marketplace as such. What Nokia brings to the picture, it's a strong marketing muscle that we can offer on the local and global basis. What it means in practice? Different types of marketing activities that we can run. Because it could be either ATL campaign. Previous year I saw several here operator campaigns which were, you know, in ATL campaigns. So there was Nokia device, there was service and applications, there were data plan from the operator of Hugo. Exactly this is what we would like to support all the time. There are several opportunities in terms of Nokia own pages, media that we buy, and in terms of digital marketing activities that we are doing and supporting with the applications as such. There are some certain campaigns that we can do just dedicated to applications, not only to the devices. And of course there are several types of media that we are using on a regular basis, right? Newsletters, we support with the events, hackathons, workshops, seeding devices towards developers. We can influence the merchandising in the marketplace to be promoted with the applications. In terms of monetization opportunities, so where is the money? Where is the revenue that I can drive? There is this Microsoft Advertising SDK, currently available in 18 markets, that actually enables this in-application advertisement, which, you know, every click which is there, it's paid, clicked and paid per click with the model click per view. And also there are third-party ad networks supported, like, for example, Google AdMob as well. And we started to heavily work on the operator billing as such, because Nokia Store Premium SMS shows that there are excellent opportunity if we bring the billing to the end-user perspective on top of the credit card payment. Also, we work very, very heavily on the local basis with Microsoft to support the messages with the developers as such. I can only highlight different style of the communication here, because in Poland we use, for example, Microsoft Windows News Center, blogs. Nokia, we use the dedicated applications, things that we may have on the digital marketing. We support certain activities in terms of palette or menu of the applications that we go with the launch of the device as such. And of course, several industry events, electronic PR, EPR around the business applications to be available as such. In terms of where actually we should start, I would say it's very simple. Nothing complicated, because the tools and development tools are already there. Meaning that just you can start using .NET environment with Visual Studio just to create the applications as such, because the developer tools are in place. Nothing new, nothing to be, you know, learned from the scratch. Just use the available components of the Visual Studio or phone emulators or XNA Game Studio as such. All the documentation, all SDKs, all the information, support, Q&As are available. If, for example, you would go here to this developer.nokia.com, and then you will say you will find a place also for Windows Phone development as such. In terms of the local support, which I strongly believe, and actually this is the one which creates the real ecosystem, the local support, we can put several activities here with Nokia Bulgaria colleagues in this one. We support with devices, seeding devices, test devices. We put trainings, workshops. We take the colleagues who come here for global and make these ones. We create the hackathons. We can support with several universities program here. Whatever is only locally relevant, we can support for creating the local applications. From my personal point of view, the top important is that we have Kaloyan Kanov here, we have Martin Kushev, who are here in Bulgaria, who are here in Sofia, speak Bulgarian language, can support you with all this information which is here within, you know, 15-20 minutes reach. This is extremely big value that, of course, we can offer on the local basis for development of the applications, supporting with tools, trainings, whatever is needed to create these applications, which of course, we would like to encourage you to create, develop, and then later on publish to the marketplace. So that's all that we prepared for today in terms of Windows Phone ecosystem. And just maybe last 2-3 minutes for questions.
Why micro-SIM cards? Why did you choose micro-SIM cards in Lumia series? Do you think that Apple strategy is right with the micro-SIM cards?
Should I reply in English or? Всъщност, причината за микросим картите е по-скоро не бих я насочил към сравнение с Apple или другите участници на пазара.
По-скоро други участници използват
микросим картите.
HTC. Много малко.
Sony Ericsson, всъщност Sony вече.
Също така, Sony Ericsson. Няма значение. Идеята, всъщност, причината за микросим картите, я бих разгледал по-скоро в еволюцията на самите устройства. Знаете, стандартната сим карта се използва вече доста дълго време на пазара. В момента говорим за микросим. Със сигурност сте запознати с това, което информацията, която в интернет пространството, в момента се работи на нов стандарт. Това по-скоро е развитие на стандартите, които се използват в индустрията. Не бих го насочен в посока на сравняване между различни производители. По-скоро стандарт, който би позволил други компоненти да бъдат подобрени и това в крайна сметка доведе до по-добрата работа на устройството и оттам по-доволни крайни потребители. Това е причината за микросим картата.
To be honest, I'm not familiar with Nokia Store, but and I don't know if Bulgarian developers can deploy their applications on Nokia Store, but how you are going to contribute to include, for example, Bulgaria on the developers map for Windows Phone? Because now we are talking about how important are developers and the applications, but actually, at the moment, it's very hard to create and deploy application for Windows Phone 7 because you can do the only way to do this is through resellers. So basically, we don't have opportunity to upload our applications on the marketplace so easy. So, is there any way to help that to become actually Soon.
Maybe I will start with the first question because there was the comment on this Nokia Store. So Nokia Store is yes. Absolutely available. You can just register and develop directly.
I've mentioned that Nokia Store. Because maybe this experience might help countries like Bulgaria to be included sooner.
And actually, this is the point which you point, because with the Nokia Store, we have, like, say, several years of experience. Mm-hmm. We build it from the scratch, right? Of course, we masterpiece, and then we go to the place where we are right now with the numbers. Now, with Marketplace, this is exactly like we have the same story. We start from the infant phases, I would say, right? So right now, to support the Marketplace, you know, in the quick solution, in terms of availability, we have to use this, like you mentioned, reseller or intermediate, say,
yeah,
upper market, for example, for mm-hmm. that one, right? Just to speed up. And of course, we want to go as soon as possible for the way that Bulgarian developers, for example, can go directly to the marketplace. We are not there yet. We work on it. So the quick win in terms of these devices which will be available, like Kalenan was describing, you know, quite soon in the market, is to have a quick win solution to support this with this opportunity and then build, you know, as soon as possible to the next one as well.
Thank you.
Въпрос за локализацията, кога ще има, да кажем, възможност да писане с българска клавиатура в Windows Phone?
The question was about the Bulgarian language and the Bulgarian keyboard. Естествено, локализацията също е част от преживяването, което искаме да предоставим и работим сериозно по въпроса. В момента работим по въпроса приложение, което да предоставя българска клавиатура, да бъде налично в телефоните, така че се надяваме, че много скоро след старта на тези устройства, приложението ще е достъпно от Marketplace, за сваляне от Marketplace. Така че и потребителите в България също ще имат възможност да ползват българска клавиатура за управление.
Тя не е нейки клавиатура на операционната система. Тоест, ако направите приложение, което има такава късна клавиатура, то вече има такива. И то поддържа българска клавиатура, то означава, че никъде да бъде, обаче няма.
Това е част от информацията. Наистина, това, което се опитах да обясня, че в момента работим върху варианта с приложение, естествено локализацията на самия софтуер, т.е. операционната система като такава също е в процес на развитие, така че работим по въпроса целият софтуер, включая клавиатурата, включая интерфейса на телефона, да стане достъпен на български и това също ще бъде представено на пазара. Въпросът е, че, както стана ясно от самата презентация, предлагаме наистина сериозни възможности на всички участници в екосистемата. Това, което направихме максимално бързо след представянето на устройствата пред света, в световен мащаб, да ги направим достъпни за България. Естествено, локализацията, това е процес, който търпи развитие. наши модели преди това също са минали през този процес, така че и Windows Phone също ще мине през процеса на локализация и това ще е достъпно за, за български потребители.
Thank you very much, Leslie. Thank you for this opportunity.